guys, so this is the haul. The drugstore haul you guys been asking for. I went to Rite Aid and I went to Target, but I have it on my Rite Aid bag. So I just wanted to buy some drugstore products to see what works best, and some of them I haven't even used them before, so I'm gonna try it. Then I'm gonna do a tutorial with the drugstore products, and then we're gonna see how it looks. So some of them I've heard good things about it, some of them I just researched a little bit, and then the other ones I just wanted to try it and to see, you know, how it goes on my skin, if it's worth it. But these are all drugstore products, so let's see. The first one is the City Manny. Who the hell is Manny? The City Mini Palette from Maybelline, New York, and it's called the Downtown Sunrise. And it's like this. I don't know if you guys can see it. So I love this because it has like this nice neutral colors, and then it has like three little shimmers. So it's like silver, it has like baby pink, and it has this really peachy slash pink, and then we have like brown, and we can use all these nice little colors. Like this can be for the brow bone and transition, and you know, etc. So this was $9.99. so for a drugstore, I think it's a good price. I mean, you do get all the nice little colors in one thing, and you can just carry it around. I think it's good, but now let's see when we try it on, how good it is. This is one of my favorite masks. It's called Yes. And this one is coconut, and it says it hydrates and restore. It's ultra hydrating, so we're gonna be trying this before I do the tutorial. I'm gonna apply it, and So it says, Yes to Going Cuckoo for coconut, which provides intense moisture for ultra smooth skin. So it's $3. So, and this I needed one. I really did try. It's really good to take off makeup to clean your skin before applying makeup or before going to sleep. So I'd rather just put like some kind rounds, whatever wipes, put some there, and it just comes right off. And for the eyebrows, I wanted to buy something different. I wanted to buy like a pencil. So I saw the e.l.f. has this pencil, and then it has a little I forgot the name of this, but you know what I mean. And then I bought neutral brown, so let's see how this goes. Then for foundation, I already have I tried this before for my Halloween tutorial. The Milani Conceal Imperfect 2-in-1 is a foundation and concealer, and it's full coverage. It's really, really good. The thing is that they don't have that many shades. So I got the shade in Sand, and it's a little too dark for me. It would have looked nice in the summer, but now that it's winter, I look like a freaking ghost. So this will not be working that much, but I can mix it up. So it's really full coverage. So I would like, I think it was like $12. I don't know, I'll put the price right here. Another thing from e.l.f., I really didn't do my research on this, but I bought the e.l.f. Perfect Blend Concealer. It looks like this. It's really small. And then I wanted to try another concealer, so I went and I bought the NYX HD Studio Photogenic Studio Concealer, and this one, I heard it works wonders. Again, when I went to Target, they didn't have that many shades, so I bought the shade CW05, and hopefully it's my color. It's a little white, but whatever, we can work with it, right? And then I bought a lot of e.l.f. I bought this blending sponge from e.l.f. It looks nice. I mean, it's pink, so I bought it. Another foundation I bought was the Wet n Wild foundation, the Photo Focus. It's in the shade Cream Beige. I've heard good reviews about this. I've seen bad reviews also. I'm gonna be using this today as well. And then lastly, I bought the Maybelline Master Chrome Metallic Highlighter. I heard really good reviews on this one, so I was like, I'm buying this. Okay, so these are all the products I bought, and I didn't buy that many. So now I'm gonna be doing a tutorial with all these products. I will be doing that now, so just keep on watching. gonna say, I liked the foundation, but it wasn't really my color. It was a little bit darker. It was, I would say, medium coverage, but it's good for the price that we pay. We're only paying $6, so it's okay. The eyeshadow has a bit of a fallout, so it was okay. The e.l.f. concealer I used it as a primer because it sucked as concealer, so don't even waste your money. This is a good concealer, the HD NYX. I really like that one. This, look at this. It's amazing. You guys have to get it. It's worth the $10. $10. The $10. Whatever, I can't even see. What else? The brow pencil, I think it's nice. I mean, I think it was like $4 or something. And I think it's, I mean, if you want to go on the go and, you know, you just want to do it and you have the little thingy, I forgot the name of this, but whatever. I think it's okay for the price. If you're going to work or something, I don't think it's bad. I think my eyebrows look good. I couldn't find a good eyeliner. Can't find it, actually. I have an e.l.f. eyeliner, and a liquid gel liner, and I like using that one, but I don't have it with me. So I just put any eyeliner here, and I decided just to use my lashes. Overall, everything is okay. I really enjoy the foundation and the concealer, the highlighter, and the brow pencil. I think those were my four favorites. Oh, and I forgot to mention, the name is all scratched out, but I'll put the name down in the description box. Best mascara ever, and I think it's like $10. So this one is good. So yeah, I hope you guys liked the tutorial. If you guys want to see more looks, more drugstore hauls, or more looks with drugstore products, just leave it down in the comment box. And yeah, guys, that's all. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.